Welcome back to another riveting episode of Analyze a Random. And today, I haven't done a random in a while. I think it's a lot more fun to pick friends that are either other YouTubers or pro players and kind of like go into what their play style is and you know, delve into it. Today is a follow-up, though, to Sir Wildcat himself. We did an Analyze on Wildcat probably 5 seasons ago. Man, there's a lot of people who landed here. He landed top of Polar with like 5 other people here. It looks like 6 other people. Uh-oh, that guy's gonna go for the pickaxe. Tyler's not one of those idiots. He does have shitty aim though. Point blank, you missed 14 bullets. He hit 3, Tyler, come on. Got a chest there. No chest up top. There is a floor spawn above. Looks like he's jumping to look up there. He knows it. Nothing there. Mine through the wall. I think Tyler's been watching me. This is my route. This is my route. Opens it up. That is not a good gun to see. He took 1 pickaxe, probably. I think he's at 80 health right now, so he has nothing. There's a guy over on top of the Dyson as well, he sees. He knows one guy just fought there inside the opposite castle. He doesn't know his health pool. He's not going to push him. That's probably the smart play. I agree. A gray pistol and a gray burst are not, burst SMG are not good. There's the flint knock. That's actually going to be his shotgun for now. I wish the replay mode, they would go into more depth with it, and it would be similar to, like what they had for the World Cup. That way you could see like Wildcat's health and his loadout and like what build he's on. They don't have any of that. Oh, Tyler takes the drum gun. I don't know if I would. The drum gun, it got hit really hard with a nerf. All right, so he took 2 pickaxes. He's at 60 white plus the 50 blue. He wouldn't have picked up that if he was at, you know, 80 white. He couldn't even use it. Looks like he's gonna go for the guy down here. Oh, this guy's weak. He's bandaging up. Tyler doesn't really know how weak he is, though. He is one shot to his pistol. He just jumps on in, whiffs it, but then kills him anyway. Oh. So, when you don't have a shotgun, it's really not that bad to use a flint knock. A flint knock is super strong. Tyler upgrades the rifle to the AK. He still has a flint knock in his shotgun slot. His SMG slot, I'm not sure what it is. I think it's a drum gun, maybe? That's weird. The hell? Oh, he must have been doing challenges. Another mini shield. He wants to take that with him. So he's going toward the campfire right now. He sees the guy across, probably. He wants to get up to full health. That's the thing. He wants to get to full health. Use the campfire, open that up. Ooh, blue AR. He'll probably change that for the AK. Tyler's not a big AK fan, I know that. And I really don't think that's a big problem. The AK, I like it personally, but with the way the game works, the first weapon you usually drop to pick up other weapons or utility items is your SMG. And if you have a regular AR, your regular AR doubles as an SMG. So it's not bad. Oh, he sees that guy right in front of him. Gonna build. Oh, hits him white. The dude just goes down. What a bot. What a bot. He just murdered him. Does he hear the guy above him? Oh, he does. He's just trying to have fun and Wildcat's just killing him. There's another guy up there. Tyler's gonna walk around and drink that real quick. That is so funny. So he should look for a shotgun here. No shotgun. Ooh, will he take the auto shotty? Yeah, blue tack. That's better. Block a couple shots. This guy is a bot. He knows it's a bot. Just gonna do shot build, shot build. Yeah, that was pretty easy play. He did get hit once there, so I think total health right now he's about 180. I can't actually check unless I hit the map button. And even then, it only shows it up here, yeah. He's about 180 right now. That's not bad. That's not bad. He is just killing people. What? I mean, this was an early drop, so I guess it makes sense for people to be around here, but it's weird. Just this part of the map in general is usually not that choked with people. Picks up one in Snobby over there. Zone is pulling to his east, though. He still has a minute before it starts. Yeah, yeah. He basically has a couple minutes before it hits him, so that's not a big deal. He might loot up top. Ooh, that's really laggy. Really laggy. So far, not bad. I'm not sure on his loadout. He's looking for a thingy here. Yeah, he's doing challenges. he's killing all pro players as well. So far, he's got 5 kills. He's killed all the members of Liquid on their alt accounts, of course. He got Vivid, took out 72. You bop mop chap with the tac shotgun. It's all of Team Vit or all of Team Liquid. I'm sorry. Nobody else around him though right now. He's probably just gonna mine some materials and go towards zone. Oh, someone's flying above him. That's weird. That guy doesn't show up on the radar. Oh, he lasered though. So we hit him three times there for shield, but didn't pop the shield, which means this guy's out of his mind. And yeah, he's gonna kill him. There's no doubt. So that guy was really dumb for coming back to push Wildcat after he lost 90 shield. But Tyler knew the guy had 200 health. He hit him three times with an AR, did roughly 95 damage, and he didn't pop the shield. So when you hit somebody's shield and it breaks, you know that they were under 100 if you hit them twice, right? 60 damage. Blue AR does 33. You hit twice, it does 30-60 roughly at the damage range it was. You know the guy would have been above 150 or at 200 based on if you heard the shield break noise. So right now he's got a blue combat, purple scar. I don't know what's in his 3 slot. Looks like he has redeploy. Nope. Did not have redeploy. Just a launch pad. He's going for the top of Stunt Mountain. Okay. Oh, this was before the event even. I told Wildcat, send me a game you thought you did pretty decent in solos. He doesn't play many solos, so it makes sense, I guess. It's a chest here. He might use the bush. His healing option is a bandage. He sees that guy down low. Grab the bandage, grab the baller. He's going to go above the guy. He won't go down low. He's going to maintain his height advantage. It looks like he has a challenge up here on the top of Stunt Mountain, too. I'm not sure what's supposed to be up here. Oh, on the top of the peaks, that challenge. That one's old. He's still mining mats. I'm going to actually bring this up. I guess this doesn't help, does it? We can't see his item slots. Man, they should really improve the replay mode so we could see more. I would like it if we could see some items here. He has a sniper, though. He's got a regular bolt. That's a headshot. Oh, that was a good shot. Might have been above him by a millimeter, but that was a pretty good shot. He can peek heavy right now because he has a bush. 47 shield. 23 white. He broke the shield. So the guy's at roughly 70 health right now. 50 health. 25 health. One shot to his AR at this range, the body. Oh, he's gonna chase him. He's pissed. I can tell you he's mad. He's gonna chase his ass. This guy is so weak. The guy has nowhere to go, though. Oh, he's not gonna be able to box up in time. Cone the top. Oh, that was really laggy. That works. He traded his bush for the kill. Ooh, okay. One mini or a med kit? Did he take both? No, he left the mini. Maybe he has max minis and bandages. I think he actually had minis and bandages. That's what he's running. He's running sniper, combat, scar, bandages, and mini shields. So he maxed out on mini shields right there, and he changed the bandage for a med kit. See that guy? He does see that guy. He's gonna go for him too. That guy has no shield. Easy kill. He is just finding everybody with no health, really. Oh no, the poor soccer skin. The poor soccer. That was a new generation soccer skin. Upgrades the combat to the pump. I've been liking the pump a lot lately, so I can totally agree on that. He's gonna pyramid himself. Save materials, but still get the heal off. He goes from like 180 to 200, right? Yeah, he's about 180 still. Oh, he wants the comp. Wait. No, he's still holding the pump. Okay. He's still holding the pump. Yeah, so this is a really common strat. I told you guys earlier, a full auto AR can kind of hold the SMG slot and the AR slot. So he has a sniper. He has a shotgun. He has an AR, and it's a full auto AR, the SCAR. And that AR also doubles as an SMG for a spray weapon, which lets him have two different open slots besides for like healing. You know, you have one for your healing slot, but one is also kind of a utility slot. And in his utility slot, he holds double heals. Oh, okay, he wanted to build, but he didn't want to build. So Wildcat has a huge advantage right now. His pump, cone the top of him. Yep. Replace it. This guy's clueless. Shotgun 78. 110. Yeah, easy. That guy was not doing anything. So what that guy should have done is probably protect himself with stairs. So you can stare over yourself. And that would have blocked him and then maybe edited it out. Another guy pushing up. Tyler's gonna try to hit a snipe shot. The tree saved the guy. That would have hit him for sure. It's pretty good, holding the high ground. Tries to focus somebody else that's building up. Launch pad, he's gonna focus this guy in the air. If he hits him a couple times with AR, he's screwed. That's gonna hurt him enough. He pops shield with that. Edit through, break in. He's a little aggressive right now. That's why I'd say it's a little aggressive. Got the replace. Nice edit. Ah! Oh, it didn't go off. Ah! Oh god, yeah, he ramped it. He ramped. Gotta hit the snipe shot. Nope. Goes for the AR. Goes for the reload. This is a great loadout, though. I love this loadout, personally. He's just gonna shoot the ball and grief it. That way nobody can take it. That's okay. He's gonna grab this, push the house. So far, so good. I would say not many mistakes at all. The main thing I would do differently when it comes to takes, like wall takes and stuff, I usually pyramid the top, and then I go for a wall take, not a roof, because roofs let you get edited on a lot easier. I don't like that, and it bugged me. So the reason is, like, I go for the pyramid, I pyramid them, and once they're pyramided, they can't edit through the roof themselves because they can't edit my cone. And then I go for the wall take. I usually use a ramp on the side, and I go for a wall take that way because it makes it a little bit easier for me. But, yeah, you going for roof edits is a little sketchy. The fact he stood on his roof as well gave the guy a chance to edit him in and put a trap down. He didn't get it off in time, but it could have happened. So, let's continue here. Wildcat pushes this guy. This guy's at 150. You gotta understand that we know the health of everybody, but when you don't know the health of everyone, it's usually safe to assume they're 150, at very least. Most people we fight are 200, so kind of sucks. This guy is roughly 147-ish, 145. He doesn't want to get out of the baller. He doesn't know if he's up or down low. He's looking for him. He thinks he's up top probably right now because of that metal ramp. He just saw him, though. Ooh, that was a close no-scope. That was not a good play from the other guy. Wildcat's just gonna break in. Roof himself anyway. Trying to break through everything. Sorry for the lag. That's just the game. This guy is just. Oh, Tyler just was like, I'm gonna one pump you. That was a little ballsy too. He thought the guy was bad, so he pushed him aggressively, but even a bad player, right hand peeks you on that door with a pump shotgun. They can hit you for 190. It's a lot. All right, not too shabby. Up to 11 elims, sitting at 200 health. He's looking real healthy. He sees a guy right to his left. Tyler, what are you looking at? Okay, there we go. Hits the guy with the sniper, sprays him. The dude doesn't even know what's going on. That guy's clueless. I mean, never mind. That guy was a pro player. He just killed Ghost Bizzle. Get owned, Bizzle, on your other account. What were you doing? Got bot mop. He might change the med kit. Is he still holding the med kit? He must have max med kits, right? Otherwise, he'd pick him up. What is he holding? I don't even know. Two stacks of mini shields? There's no way you drop minis for a chug jug unless you have more minis. Or big or slurp or something. Either way, he's got a chug, whatever. He does not, somebody's in there. Who would hide in there? I would never expect it either, honestly. Where's zone pulling? Oh, he's got zone. There goes his ball, though. Oh, did he hear the guy behind him? Oh, this is a little scary. Oh, he blocked behind him. That's safe now. That's good. Just gonna build up on the hill. Going for a snipe shot. That guy's no way he launches toward him, right? That'd be so dumb. Tyler just shoots it out. Not a bad play. The thing is, if he gets hit by this heavy sniper, the guy's gonna launch and land on him. Oh, Wildcat just saw the guy behind him. He's gonna go for an edit snipe headshot. This is gonna be great. I was just gonna peek the ramp. Oh, he sucks, though. Wildcat's fucking trash. I can't let you guys watch this, man, if you do. Oh, no. He's trying to trap him. This guy is clueless. There you go. All right, he'll upgrade his bolt for the heavy. That guy was such a noob. I mean, that was a really good player. That was probably... That was FaZe Mongrel. That was Mongrel on the US servers. Fucking Mongrel, get owned. How many people are left? We're looking at a solid 4 left on third zone. Just closing in. He's got 13 elims. He's looking to hit a nice little... Oh, there's 2 people fighting over there. That's so weird the way that, that ends up looking. Good play. Blocking off that side to make sure you can focus without getting shot. He might be peeking a little too heavily, though. He might need to put one more wall facing that way. Going for the 50 cals. Going for the 50 cals. Okay, edits a window. Whenever you see a window edit preemptively, it's a little sketchy. Tyler's just biding his time right now. He figures he's got the high ground, right? Like, the zone does pull away from him down the hill, but it's not an issue because you can just slide down the hill and build. But he's got the highest point in the zone right now. There's only 4 left. He's just going to abuse the fact he has the most overpowered gun in the game and go for a one-shot body from a 50. Maybe a headshot. When you're using a 50, pretty much everybody only aims for the body because it almost always kills everybody anyway. He's just letting shots fly right now. Oh, launch pad. He might not launch pad. He might use... What's he looking for? Oh, he's just trying to get max mats again. Make sure he's full. He didn't pick up any of that stuff, so he's like... He's got to be 3,000 mats, roughly. He sees the guy flying inside the slipstream. Okay. Oh, he's landing on that guy for sure. Try to block him off with the tree. Not a bad play. Little 90 up. Nice. You got 90 to over. Get your own box that way. Okay, good. He pyramided you, though. He has a 50 as well. If he hasn't reloaded it, this is a time you could go for the peak play. Oh, block it. Nice. Edited him. Drop the traps. He might go for it. Wildcat loves the trap play. There we go. Knocks out his wood, replaces it. This is good so far. It's his metal. The guy's trying to like test the walls and catch him off guard. He's gonna edit the roof and pump him. I'm calling it now. This is why you don't do roof edits nearly as often. It's kind of scary. Well, that guy did not do what he wanted to there. This gives Wildcat high ground for free. The guy could use an impulse and come back up with it, but unlikely. He's shooting out launch pads preemptively. Pretty good so far. I haven't seen a lot of mistakes. Really, I haven't seen many. Except for the way he goes for wall takes. I'd be a little sketched out about that. Personally, I like going for the wall instead of the roofs. Because the roof just like... So many people have gone for roofs against me and I murder them, you know? If he peeks here, he's probably getting shot. Oh, he's trying to bait the shot. There you go. Good play. So when someone's hard peeks you like that ahead of time, you can do that. You can bait the shot pretty easily. If he bodies this guy, though, he will kill him. Did he take damage? How many people are left? That was a 1v1. What's Wildcat's health at? 175. Tyler landed on high, but I don't think he has zone. No, he doesn't. It pulls to his right. But he's closer to zone than this other guy. This other guy is a 7-kill gamer. Wildcat's a 13-kill gamer. Oh, look out for the 50. And then he 50s him in the body and kills him. See what I mean? That 50 is so broken. A lot of people are not going to be 200 health, especially if they're aggressive players. He tries to... Oh, he's using the World Cup spray. Yeah, so a lot of people who play aggressive aren't going to be 200, especially in the end game. You know, you spent most of your game pushing people, unless the people you pushed, you were lucky enough to get a big blue off of them or a slurp or you find chug splashes, whatever it may be. Maybe you get a drop and you get more shit out of that. The average amount of health is 150 by using campfires and mini shields, because that's the most common form of healing carried, really, is mini shields. So I thought he played really well. Really well. I didn't see many mistakes at all. Like, I mean, sure, you could say his building wasn't the greatest here and there, but nobody builds perfect all the time, so I can't say that's a problem. His aim was overall pretty good. He pushed people when he should have. The only thing I didn't like that he sketches me out on a lot is the way he takes walls from people. So the way I do it is I build a wall or I build a ramp off of the side of the bottom of their box. And then I go for a wall pickaxe where if you, I cone the roof, like I said, and once the roof's mine, they can't edit through and go above me. So it makes it a little safer to avoid them pushing out on you. But it's also just so easy to kill people if they go for a pickaxe on your roof. And it's hard to react quick enough on somebody's edit shotgun shot. So it's a little scary. They also drop you in and trap you, which sucks, but didn't end up happening. I think he only went for like one or two takes that way. And one dude was way too clueless to ever pull it off. The other guy tried, but it was a little too slow. That was a good game. 14 kills. That was good. He went for challenges too. That was a good game. Like I said, I can't say that he made many mistakes there. He didn't play super aggressive. He didn't have to. He had a 50 cal. He sat on high ground. He held it. He moved to the spots where he needed to. He held the spots he needed to. He pressured the right people. You can't fault him for not seeing that guy that was hiding in the little house behind him. He never would know that. He didn't even move. He could have not missed a couple sniper shots that looked a little easier, but again, nobody hits every shot, so I can't say that that was a mistake. The only thing I would have changed is how you take roofs, Wildcat. Be very careful with that. If you try to take my roof like that, it is almost guaranteed I'm hitting you for roughly 100, at least with a pump. With a combat, probably 70, but still, I will be able to edit my flat roof, not my cone. I'll be at my flat roof on you and shoot, but then reset it before you even have your shotgun out yet. So it's a little scary doing that. I hope you guys enjoyed, though. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to see the first time we analyzed Wildcat, link is in the description, and I will see you guys later. Bye-bye.